What is up, my Body Weight Warriors, and welcome back to another video. I actually don't know what this one is.
It's just kind of an update in general. We're gonna focus today specifically on training because there has been a lot of change to my training, as I did mention last time, which I think some of you may find interesting, but just whole routine in general.
Well, first things first is the shift from normal-ish training to like full body workouts. I'm gonna go over that one later in the video. Second is I'm trying to grow a mustache at the moment. It is Movember, so I'm trying to grow a mo for a bro. It raises money for men's health, both in terms of like cancer and also mental health. So I'm growing one of these. And I will be donating some money at the end of the month. If you want to help me, there'll be a link in the description down below if you want to also donate some money. Would highly appreciate it. Number two is that I've been getting up a lot earlier lately, like a lot earlier, actually about 5 a.m. to be precise. Not really sure the reason exactly for this. I am making a whole video about the next 28 days, which I'm kind of challenging myself to get up at that time, just in an attempt to be more productive and see if it benefits me in any way. Today we're on day two and I'm currently just feeling a little bit tired, but it does have the added bonus that when I did my first handstand session of the day at like 9:30 a.m., I'd already been up for 4.5 hours and done a bunch of work. So it was quite easy to do that and then eat something for breakfast, which was just some rice and leftover roast chicken. Which I guess brings us onto the final point, and that is the double daily sessions, splitting up the handstand stuff, doing some balanced things in the morning, then doing some more strength endurance stuff in the afternoon before the main training session, if there is a main training session, which is much less now because of the full body sessions. So I'm sure whilst you have some questions potentially about getting up at 5 a.m, just please wait for the video. There is more to it and hopefully you'll enjoy that video as well. I'm trying to do some different video ideas. But in terms of the training, the main reason for this is a question that I've kind of been asking myself a lot lately. And that is the idea of, do I see myself as a coach or as an athlete? And I think initially when I first got into training, like I saw myself as an athlete and I wanted to be performing at a very high level, for example. But the more and more I've got into this, the more I realized that the most enjoyment that I get out of this, not that I don't enjoy training, but just the thing that I really enjoy doing is teaching and is coaching and sharing information. I kind of just feel that I get a lot more joy when I hear, you know, one of my clients has got their first pressed handstand or has touched their toes for the first time or X, Y, and Z, as opposed to me getting, you know, a few more seconds in the one-arm handstand. Not that that is not enjoyable, just that the latter is what gives me more motivation to do what I'm doing. The full body is partly so I can spend more time and energy focused on the handstand, which is, to be honest, the main goal at the moment and the thing that I really want to tick off and have wanted to tick off for a long time now. So it's kind of the final push, stripping away those kind of excess bits and pieces that weren't necessarily 100% useful, keeping it really basic and bare bones, and then focusing on the handstand. But the other reason is also just to give me more time to essentially work, to make videos, to do coaching, the things that I'm just really enjoying at the moment. I don't really see myself ever not training. Like, training is still a big focus for me. I'm still spending 10 hours a week probably in the gym, but it's just a little bit less than I was doing initially, which just, as I said, gives me a little bit more time and freedom to do the other things that I've got on. I think having a physical practice is just an essential part of life, and I think a lot of people miss that, especially when they get older. So for me, it's something that will always be there. It's just, at the moment, my main focus isn't how good I can be, it's how good can I make other people. But I certainly don't think you can do the second part, the coaching part, without properly doing and experiencing the actual training side, being there firsthand, understanding the process to then take somebody else through it. But yeah, that's kind of where I've been on things. That's kind of why I'm moving to full body split. But I'll probably still be making some good gains when it comes to strength and flexibility anyway. The obligatory pre-workout coffee, as always. This time was a little bit different. We have the espresso from our friends at Extract Coffee.
This is their strongman espresso. They do this every single November. And like this pitiful mustache, it also helps to support Movember. I think this year they're actually donating things to things that also benefit men and women. Either way, it's a good coffee, helps to support a good cause, so you can sit back and enjoy your cup of coffee in the morning, guilt-free, and knowing that you're doing something better in the world. Let's go and train. A huge amount of detail when it comes to the handstand stuff at the beginning of the session. Just know there was some. That's what the Road to One-Arm Handstand series is for, and there'll be another episode updating that soon. Basically, I've been very inconsistent in the past sort of 2 and a bit weeks in terms of training for both strength and handstand stuff, mostly because of traveling, teaching workshops, so that always throws things off. I have been training, but just not like I would, so balance has been bad, and it's taken really the past week of some consistent training to get back to something reasonable. But it's definitely moving in the right direction, almost back to where it was beforehand. And I still feel confident at that end of 2019 10 second hold, although I have had one already. So on to today's session. It is a full body training session. And the reason I wanted to share this is because, to be honest, I've never really liked full body training sessions. They've never been something I've enjoyed doing until this current routine. Full body sessions, I just tend to find that I didn't have enough time, or I felt too tired, or I felt like I was missing out on extra volume or extra things that I could be doing. But because I'm really stripping back my training at the moment and focusing on doing the basics and focusing on a few key movements, I don't have that sensation. I just feel like I'm doing the work that is needed. And so the change is very different. And it doesn't feel like I'm missing out. It feels like I'm just doing what I need to do. There's very little accessory work, if any. For the upper body, it's mainly weighted chin-ups, working kind of 3 to 5 reps, nice and simple. And then that is gonna be paired with handstand push-ups on the wall and just using parallettes because I'm trying to give my wrists a little bit of a break. Again, just core movements for the upper body, really two things I wanna nail down. You will notice that the form in some of these reps and sets is less than ideal. And the reason for that is I'm less concerned about perfect form with everything and more just concerned about grinding through and getting a certain amount of volume and work done in the session. So I do allow for a little bit of lapse in form because also the rest periods are a little bit lower. So it's a brutal workout. It's not long, but I just feel like my entire body is trashed after it. After all of the upper body stuff, literally two movements, nice and straightforward, I moved on to just some podium deadlifts. So podium deadlifts are just with elevation of the feet, so it just increases the range of motion slightly. And again, just a simple basic movement. It's gonna load basically all of the lower body and especially lower back. And I still have some low-key goals about lifting, and I'm just treating this more as like general preparation for the future when I have more time to dedicate to lifting heavy weights. But for the moment, that is not the case. I'm doing sets of 6 to 8 here. The weight is not particularly heavy, as you will notice, but again, I'm doing like 90 seconds rest between sets. So it's gonna be sub-maximal loading and more just like a little bit of strength endurance, less of a focus on like 3, 4, 5 minute rest and maximal strength. After the deadlifts, I finished up with a tiny bit of accessory work, but just 1 to 2 sets. Doing some incline bicep curls. If you watched my video on how to break through plateaus of the chin-up, you'll know that this one is to aid with that top position of the chin-up, which I'm also working on with the first exercise by adding some pauses at the top. So just some incline bicep curls and then also some incline tricep extensions, again, to help with handstand push-up. Two very simple movements, just for some higher rep stuff, like 10 to 15 reps. Just to help get a little bit of volume in there, but not too much that, again, it's gonna completely fry me so I can't train the other things that I want to do. But that is basically the session, nice and simple. Really, that's how strength training should be. It doesn't need to be complicated, it needs to be simple, but it needs to be consistent, and that is the key. But that is basically it for this week, guys, when it comes to the update on the training and what is happening. I hope you found it interesting. If you did find it interesting, then feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this one. What do you reckon to full body workouts? I'm on the fence. I'm enjoying these ones. In the past, I haven't enjoyed them, as I said. What do you think of it? If you just enjoyed this video, you can hit that thumbs up button and support the channel. Right next to it is that subscribe button if you're enjoying the Bodyweight Warrior Tribe. But that has been it for this week, guys. I'll catch you in the next episode. Have a strong week and peace.